wear protective eye gear if you'd like to see it. You could use welder's glasses, but it's dark, so forget about that. You're not going to look at the sun tonight. But there it is, Venus moving across the sun. Very rare, Patrick Crawford.
Yeah, it's always, I always find it very interesting when you see something that you can't say, oh, I'll catch it next time
it happens. There's no catching this one
next time. No, not 105 years from now, that ain't, unless something amazing happens with science and technology. But the clouds today, they held on, made it a little hard to see that, but we were dealing with some showers and storms. That's what produced the cloud cover that we had out there this afternoon as the sun was beginning to set. As we take a look, though, at the numbers today, we had enough sunshine through the morning and afternoon that we warmed up quite a bit in some areas. Look at the lows this morning. This is just from a few areas that reported the numbers, and you could see temperatures were down only into the middle and upper 70s out there, and then high temperatures today for most of the area was well into the 90s. Look at Audubon Park, 96 degrees, 93 at the airport. I think temperatures tomorrow maybe 1 or 2 degrees cooler than they were today, but still it's going to be very warm. Also, that humidity making it feel much warmer. Now, here's a look at the radar. You can see we are dealing with some isolated shower and thunderstorm activity. We've got a little bit of shower activity here in Tangipahoa Parish. Also, southeastern St. Tammany Parish. Now, this storm was a little strong. It has weakened just a bit. It had a lot of heavy rain as it moved just to the south of Slidell. But as it moves into Lake Bourne, it's starting to weaken a bit. So I'm not detecting a whole lot of lightning with that system. But I want to take a look back at the radar. This is over the past 6 hours. Look at this storm that fired up just over River Ridge, where they had rainfall totals ranging from 1.25 inch of rainfall to over 1.5 inches of rainfall. And that fell in a very short period of time. You could see how quick this storm fired up with the daytime heating. Here it comes right there. And then it dissipated out as it kind of just sat over the same area for about an hour time frame. Now, the lightning is starting to weaken with that system as it continues to push towards Lake Bourne. Not seeing much as far as lightning across the area as of right now. Watching this cold front, though, to our north. This is a big player with our weather forecast because this cold front will be influencing our weather for the next several days. Now, this front is still a little ways from the area. It's just to the north of Jackson, but it's going to continue to make its way south, closer to our viewing area, closer into southeastern Mississippi and, or I should say, southeastern Louisiana and southern Mississippi. I think this front isn't going to completely make its way through. It's going to stall over the area. And what does that mean for us? Shower and thunderstorm chances for the rest of tonight, throughout the day tomorrow, and also Thursday, more storms will be possible. And here's what I'm talking about. This is our forecast model. It shows me two things. It shows me cloud cover, but it also shows me the precipitation as far as showers and thunderstorms. This is tomorrow at around 3:30, and you can see some thunderstorms firing up along that stationary boundary. Also some storms for the Mississippi Gulf Coast. So as long as this front stays over the area, we have to keep those shower and storm chances in the forecast throughout the day. You can see at around 6:30 tomorrow, more isolated to scattered thunderstorm activity. It's going to be a little tricky as far as temperatures go. I think tomorrow highs close to 90 degrees, but if you do get some rain, temperatures will be noticeably cooler thanks to the rainfall. Now, speaking of the rainfall, this is a forecast model estimating the amount of rainfall, not just for tomorrow, not just for Thursday, not just for Friday, but I have this going all the way through the weekend. Now watch what happens. You can see the purple shading that starts to make its way over the viewing area, even some maroon shading off to the east. That means rainfall totals anywhere from 2 to 4 inches, and a lot of this is going to come over the weekend. So we are looking at some rainy conditions for Saturday and Sunday. Temperatures out there this evening, they're warm, 84 at the lakefront. Slidell, you're currently at 81 degrees, also 81 in Hammond. As we take a look at the temperature forecast, tomorrow morning, it's going to be another warm start. Everybody in the mid to upper 70s, and then tomorrow afternoon, we'll be hovering into the middle and upper 80s, and then close to 90 degrees for highs. And then tomorrow evening, another warm night. Temperatures will be into the lower 80s and upper 70s. So there's a look at your detailed 7-day exactcast. I'm going to keep the shower and thunderstorm chances through the week. Right now, Friday might be the best day as far as avoiding any showers or storms. And there you can see the storm chances for the weekend go up. Temperatures do go down a few degrees. So that's the one nice thing we do get, Scott, with the shower and thunderstorms. We get some cooler temperatures, but that's it. That's the only way we're going to cool off is if we get some of that rain.
All right, Patrick, thanks.
You got